I feel like the most naked and exposed in a way when I play, but it's also like yeah, I feel really honest. The trombone to me is like something that I've been holding on to like the bigger part of my life. So it's yeah, it's really special to me. Whatever mood I'm in, it's like always when I play, I feel a little better. My family's been singing in choirs and stuff, but they are not at all into the jazz scene, or they don't know anything about that. And I was a bit of a like a tomboy when I was a kid, so I was only wearing black clothes and playing with Lego and you know, playing football with the guys. So I wanted to do something that everyone was not doing. I remember that I was in line to start playing drums, but the queue was really long. There was no one playing the trombone. And I remember that my brother told me you should just start to play trombone because no one is playing that. I was 7, so it's like almost 14 years. Yeah, 14 years.
De eerste keer dat ik Ebba zag, dat was in Stockholm. Ik moest daar les geven, workshops geven. En na 3-4 dagen zei de docent van Stockholm, die zei, heb je nog tijd voordat je naar het hotel gaat, want ik heb nog een student. Die zit dan nog niet op het conservatorium, maar die is erg getalenteerd.
I met him and we had like a masterclass with all the students of the conservatory in Stockholm. And I just really liked his playing, improvisation-wise and theoretically and technique and everything.
Ze kwam binnen, zoals ze nog steeds eigenlijk is. Heel ontwapenend en heel open. Heel eerlijk, heel direct. En ze begon te spelen. En ja, ik geef nu 23 jaar les. Je merkt wel direct, zeker als iemand 16, 17 is, of het echt een talent is. In het geval van Ebba was het absoluut het geval.
It came to the point that we had like a private lesson that same week. And we really, yeah, I felt like I was really interested to learn more, you know, from him.
Toen heeft ze besloten, ik wil, als mijn middelbare school klaar is, wil ik bij Ilja studeren. En toen was ze te laat met het inschrijven voor de studiejaar. En toen bestond er een kans dat zij niet geplaatst zou worden. Toen heeft zij gezegd, nee, ik kom sowieso. En dat vond ik zo bijzonder, om dan in het buitenland te gaan wonen zonder dat je dan echt daadwerkelijk gaat studeren. Want dat was nog niet duidelijk. Uiteindelijk is het wel goed gekomen, gelukkig.
Thank you.
Now you see how much I do for my students. But this is your size.
Wow. Okay.
All right. So what shall we do? Just play and then do the regular stuff, right?
Yeah. Usually on the lesson I bring one standard each week, and then like I prepare it, and then we talk about it on the lesson. So I just had a question about like how to make my solo more varying in the sense that.
In de lessen komt die volwassenheid en die zelfstandigheid die komt naar voren, omdat ze eigenlijk al een heel erg duidelijk beeld heeft van wat ze wil.
Okay.
De kracht van Ebba is dat ze een sterk muzikaal concept heeft, goed trombone kan spelen. En dat ze gewoon haar eigen plan trekt en daar mensen bij zoekt die haar kunnen helpen. Als Ebba met een stuk komt, heeft ze het geschreven. Hè? Haar stukken zijn modern jazz, maar dan met een behoorlijke nadruk op het melodieuze. Past ook bij hoe ze speelt. Niet zo verticaal, heel horizontaal.
All the time play the line.
Yeah, all the time play the line. So we only solo on B.
Yeah, right.
And then it's a theme, like it's written. And then the solo is on F minor and E7 sharp 11. And then you cue to B, to the second house. Yeah, this is just as written, I hope.
Hoe mensen jouw compositie uitvoeren, hè? Dus dat... Wat jij wil zo duidelijk mogelijk op papier moet komen te staan. Iedereen heeft daar moeite mee. Van hoe schrijf ik nou iets zo op dat een drummer weet wat hij moet doen?
I have a question.
Yeah.
So we end on the on the four instead of the four end.
Yeah, on the four, yeah.
Yeah.
Da, da, da. En dat is ook wel leuk. Dan heb je dus aan het eind van de les, dan zeg je, geweldig stuk. Dat punt zou je aan kunnen passen. Oh ja, ja, ja. En dan een les erop, is er niks veranderd. Fantastisch. Maar ze heeft in ieder geval wel over nagedacht. Ze heeft een goed beeld van wat ze wil.
My first year here, I was like experiencing everything with this town and country. But I've had a girlfriend since 2.5 years. We were having like a long distance thing for 1 year. And then she decided to come here. So she's also studying at Kozars, but 1 year under me.
Like right when you were about to end high school, we got together for real. And then you had this thing with Ilya. And you decided to come here, and that was like just a few months into our relationship.
Yeah.
So then I came here like once a month or something, visiting you.
Yeah.
And slowly really starting to like the city, and also of course wanting to be close to you.
Yeah.
So yeah, luck, really lucky that I got in. Yeah. I practiced my ass off. Too.
So we both go back and forth to Sweden to play. It's really nice to not only have someone to like fall back on, but also like someone that really knows you for the way you are, because you really like, sometimes you feel like you just flew into a brand new situation, you know. So it's really nice to have someone that really knows you and respects you, you know.
The biggest change for both of us probably that we matured a lot, both in like personality-wise, but music-wise also, of course. You seem very inspired in your composing, that you're composing more than you did before.
Yeah, getting some new perspective also with being in a new place and just meeting people that you would never met before, that for me are very inspiring.
Yeah.
Like North Sea Jazz, like that kind of like get together with like jazz people from all around the world and like having a jam session until 6 o'clock and like the scene in Stockholm is really nice, but here you have like jams to choose from every night and it's close to go to Amsterdam and you know, there are different scenes that are really close by. So I think it's a lot of things happening here.
Yeah, another big difference here is that people bike everywhere, no matter the weather.
Yeah.
I guess maybe that's what got you to write Night Bike, which is my favorite song of the album.
Ah,
just
really?
because I can really see you on the bike in the night time.
In the middle of the solo. Okay. So this is like one of the first CDs I had as a child, and I really listened to it a lot from when I started playing, basically. And then I would say like what also has influenced me a lot in my playing and composing. And also this guy. These are the same guys that wrote the music for example, Pippi Longstocking and stuff like that. So it's really something that I've been growing up with, and you know, that I really been surrounded with my whole life. So that's also a very special album that I think has influenced me like on many levels a lot in my life.
Ik kom uit een andere generatie en zeker ook uit een andere generatie die op een andere manier muziek heeft leren consumeren. De huidige generatie, en daar hoort Ebba ook bij, als je een Spotify playlist hebt van jazz, je kan alles intypen, jazz, Latin jazz, smooth jazz, dan heb je zo'n lijst, waar begin je? En dan luisteren ze anderhalf minuut. En dan, nou leuk, volgende stuk. Maar de opbouw van zo'n plaat, hè, dus dat, waarom heeft een muzikant besloten om met dat stuk te beginnen en daarna dat en daarna dat. Ik hoop dat ik Ebba mee kan geven om meer daarin te duiken. Al veel meer van minder, in plaats van weinig heel veel weten.
Bad cheat, I couldn't find the trombone one.
Oh, no problem. If there's a piano thing.
Yeah, it's just, this is one of my own compositions and it kind of has the same steadiness and modality as the other
voice.
One. So maybe it's nice to dive into that one.
All right. And why do you improvise, serious question, improvise only over C minor? Why don't you get inspiration from those chords?
Ilya brings a different perspective than I've had in my previous teachers. He has a really strong method that he really goes for. And for me, it's been like a journey. Like the first year was about understanding his method a little bit. And now I feel like in the third year, it's like a nice discussion between us.
Shall we try that as well? First C minor?
I think that it's nice to just do C minor for now.
All right, good. Je eigenzinnigheid en eigenwijzigheid, dat had ze toen al, dat heeft ze nu nog steeds. Maar wat ik wel merk is, op een gegeven moment dan komt er ook wel een soort besef van oké, ik moet me wel een beetje openstellen voor mensen die misschien iets minder leuke dingen te vertellen hebben. Docenten, in andere woorden. En, want misschien hebben ze toch wel een beetje gelijk als ik dan die kant op moet. Dat heeft ze geleerd al heel snel, na dat eerste jaar. Wat is de tempo?
So it's like, I thought it was a little bit bad tempo.
Still a little bit too ticka-ticka-ticka, yeah?
But I like that.
Yeah, but can you try, it's fine that you like it, but can you try something else?
Middelandstraat. For me, it's a really inspiring street. I've never been in a similar place before. You have a lot of different cultures next to each other, all kinds of restaurants, all kinds of shops. One of the songs of my album is about this street. Usually when I write songs, it's just a thought or a feeling that I'm having, you know. So that song is more of an atmosphere I wanted to recreate. Me walking down the street in the evening, you know, like in a kind of like a mellow feeling in my body. Because I usually go here by myself or I'm alone in this room practicing or hanging out by myself most of the time, also in the days. So it was, I guess it was, it's kind of a, like a mellow tune. I'm
just det.
Men du går en läsning.
Ja, precis. Mm.
Ze heeft ontzettend veel mogelijkheden, denk ik. En zeker ook in Zweden. Ik hoop dat ze over 10 jaar nog steeds in Nederland is. Desnoods een half jaar of af en aan. Ik denk zeker dat ze, gezien haar talent, een solistische carrière tegemoet gaat. Dat hoop ik ook. En ik denk dat we haar in allerlei moderne... Dat is wel echt gaaf aan haar. Het is echt een speler van nu. Hè? Dus ik denk dat alle moderne bands en de moderne muziekstijlen... Dat zij daar heel erg goed in zou kunnen passen. Dat denk ik.
When I get some perspective, I walk a lot by the water. There is an old harbor with an old boat, and by that there's the skyline with all these modern buildings. And then there's the water in between. It's just a really nice picture. I think it captures Rotterdam in a way. Contrast and different ways. Yeah, it's always nice also in the music to have in mind. Thinking back of these 2 years, since I got here, I've got more confidence in the sense that I trust my ideas and my musicality more than I ever did before. My music is from the heart, and that's the most important thing.
NTR, speciaal voor iedereen.